They sat at both ends of the couch and watched as the fire burned out. So quiet on a winter's night, not a house light on for miles around. He said, I think I'll fill the stove, it's getting time for bed. She said, I think I'll pour some wine. How about you, she asked, and he declined. Warren, she said, maybe just for tonight, we could fill the stove with birches and watch as the fire burns bright. How long has it been? It's been quite a while. Won't you pour yourself half a glass and stay with me just a little while? But Warren, he shook his head as if she'd made some kind of joke. Birches on a winter's night, now we'll fill the stove with oak. His oak will burn as long and hard as a July afternoon. Birch will burn itself out by the rising of the moon. And you hate a cold house, same as me. Am I right or not? All right, that's true, she said. It was just a thought. But Warren, you do look tired. Maybe you should go to bed. And I'll take care of the wood tonight. Oak, he told her. Oak, she said. And she listened for his footsteps as he walked up the stairs. She pulled her sweater on her and set her wine glass on a chair. She walked down the cellar to the wood box. It was cold as an ice chest. She climbed back up with four logs, each as white as a wedding dress. And she filled the stove and poured the wine and sat down on the floor. She curled her legs beneath her as the fire sprang to life once more. And it filled the room with its hungry light and cracked as it drew air. The shadows danced a jittery waltz like no one else was there. And she stood up in the heat and she twirled around the room. And the shadows, they saw nothing but a young girl on her honeymoon. And she knew the time it would be short, soon the fire would start to fade. She thought of heat, she thought of time, and she called it an even trade.